Used to be when people talked about the end of the world, we locked them up or laughed them off. Sometimes both. But we never took them seriously. Maybe we should have. But I'm getting ahead of myself. Better to start at the beginning with the abduction of Desmond Miles, my son. This boy had no ambition, no direction, no plans for the future. What he did have was a heritage, one he chose to deny. It nearly cost him his life. He was captured and imprisoned. Those who took him believed he could help them find something. The apple. One of several artifacts we call pieces of Eden. Bits of ancient technology scattered across the globe. Some hidden, some found, all of them dangerous. Most are held by a single group, the same group that now had Desmond. You know them as Abstergo Industries. We know them as the Templars. As the enemy. We've been fighting them for thousands of years. Even longer if you believe the stories of their origins. I do. After all, I've seen the truth. That's the beauty and the horror of the Animus. A device that allows us to enter and experience the lives of our ancestors. It holds the power to change everything, to show us history the way it really happened. Up until its creation, to the victor went the spoils, went the truth. We're trying to fix that, to free minds and bodies both. But there's only so much that we can do, and the Templars have the upper hand these days. But something larger than the Assassins and Templars is approaching, bigger than all of us. And if we can't find a way to stop it, these next few weeks will probably be our last, everyone's last. In the end, it all comes down to him, to Desmond. Through the Animus, he discovered his heritage, explored the lives of his ancestors, and uncovered their secrets. When that was done, he trained. He used another ancestor to provide decades of experience in the span of a few days. It worked. We think. We hope. Soon, though, soon we'll know. That ominous date fast approaches, December 21st, 2012. None of us knows what it'll bring, only that this is where they want us to be. When it does. They've been guiding us in their own fractured, frustrating way. These voices from the first civilization, the ones who came before, a precursor race of immense power and uncertain motives. They're the ones who made the pieces of Eden. This is where they've led him, and through him, us. He stands at the entrance to this long-lost place, armed with the knowledge of Altair and the abilities of Ezio. He holds in his hands the Apple of Eden, and we stand at his side, ready to support him however we can. His name is Desmond Miles, and he has brought us to the end. Here. Let's go.
In another moment, down went Alice after it, never once considering how in the world she was to get out again.
I think we're here.
You must find the key.
Son?
Sir?
Here we go again.
Desmond?
Do you hear us?
Yeah. What happened?
The temple triggered a bleeding effect. You collapsed and entered into a fugue state.
So naturally, you dropped me into the Animus instead of, I don't know, making sure I was okay?
You weren't in any danger. Besides, the temple appeared to be communicating with you, and I didn't want to risk severing the connection. At least not until we knew what it wanted.
Right. Of course.
Son, I...
No, it's fine. I get it. And I know what I'm looking for, by the way. It's a key. Just no idea where it is, though. I guess that's why she triggered the bleeding effect.
She?
Juno, Dad. She's talking to me.
Okay, Desmond. While you were, visiting Constantinople, we picked up a software update for the Animus. I'd like to run a couple of quick tests, make sure there aren't any major issues.
All right. What do you need me to do?
We'll start simple. Walk to the marker over there. Okay, Desmond. Let's practice climbing on these objects. Run your way through this little obstacle course. That's a constraint. These are optional objectives that raise your synchronization rate. All right, Desmond. Follow the on-screen instructions and kill the two Templars. All you have to do here is jump the gap. Synchronization levels look good now. We should be able to build the world. Time to find out what the temple wants from you.
Everything all right, sir?
Yes, fine. I'm just preoccupied, that's all.
Don't forget your invitation. Master Birch will be meeting you inside.
Thank you.
Where shall I retrieve you once you're done?
Front of the Opera House. And be quick about it. Don't expect to be here long.
I'll bring her round at once.
Invitation, please. Shall I take your coat, sir?
Ladies and gentlemen, you are requested to kindly find your seats.
Good evening, sir. This way, please.
My apologies.
Evening, Haytham.
Reginald?
I can't tell you how happy I was to hear they'd mounted this revival. Gay's best work by far. Have you seen it before?
Once. My father brought me here as a child, though I remember little of it. I don't suppose tonight will afford me the luxury of a proper viewing either.
No, I'm afraid it won't. On to business, then. Do you see him?
He's seated in one of the boxes above.
The stairs are watched. You'll need to find another way up.
So is mine. I already have. Double
capacity, both against rote and for. For 'tis but fitting that we should protect and encourage cheats, since we live by them.
Sir, Black Maul, that set word of trial, comes on in the afternoon.
A thousand pardons. My apologies.
As the wench is very active and industrious, you may satisfy her that I'll soften the evidence.
Tom Gage, sir, is found guilty.
A lazy dog. When I took him the time before, I told him what he would come to if he did not bend his hand. This is death without reprieve. I may mention a book. War Tom Gag. £40. Let Betty Slidell, our saver, from the confrontation. So I can get more by her staying in.
Betty has brought more goods into our lofty ear than any driver of the game. And in truth, it is a pity to lose so good a customer.
If none of the gang take her off, she may, in the common course of business, live her 12 months longer. I love to let women escape. A good sportsman always lets the end barge his flight, because the freedom of the game depends on it. Besides, here the law allows us no reward. There's nothing to be got by the death of women, except our wives.
Without dispute, she is a fine woman.
Make haste and you, big boy. Let your friends know where I intend.
I love to make them easy one way or other.
When a gentleman is dead, penitence might break his spirit ever after. Besides, certainty gives a man a good air upon his trial.
I've and makes got a bit of stage fright.
Don't courage up with a bloom in your cheek.
But it's a pleasure to be the messenger of comfort to friends in affliction.
But it is now high time to look about me for a decent execution against next sessions. I ain't a lazy rogue. I can't forget nothing till he's aimed. A register of the
game. Jeremy's really burning up the boards tonight.
He's a marvel.
A year and a half in the service. Let me see how much the stock goes to his industry. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 gold watches. And 7 silver ones. A mighty clean dining fellow. 16 stone.
Haytham, you should have come to me. We would have found another way.
Yes, but then you would have known. For what it's worth, I'm sorry.
As am I.
Calm, please!
Over there! That's the one that had the murder!
That man there! Seize him!
Killed in the upper balconies!
Oh, my!
But I've done no wrong, I swear!
Search him. Any weapons?
I beg your pardon. No pushing, please!
Please!
Let us through!
Peace, friends, there is no danger! Peace, friends, there is no danger!
Try to remember.
It happened right in that balcony.
What are those men doing in there?
We must leave at once.
Move! Move!
Order! We must have order!
Where are you going?
I need to
I'll
get out.
On here. You search here. Down there.
Very well. If you find anyone, give a shout.
And how was the opera?
Rather dull, truth be told.
Shall we be off, then?
Aye. To Fleet and Bride.
By your command.
Fascinating. Gentlemen, I hold in my hand a key. And if this book is to be believed, it will open the doors of a storehouse built by those who came before.
Ah, yes. Those who ruled, reigned, and vanished from the world. Do we know what it is that will be held within?
It could contain certain knowledge, perhaps a weapon, or something as yet unknown, unfathomable in its construction and purpose. It could be any of these things, or none of them. They are still an enigma, these precursors. But of one thing I am certain. Whatever waits behind those doors shall prove a great boon to us all.
Or our enemies, should they find it first.
They won't. You've seen to that.
I assume you know where this storehouse is?
Ah, Mr. Harrison.
Gentlemen.
How fair your calculations?
I believe the site lies somewhere within this region.
That's a lot of ground to cover.
My apologies. Were that I could be more accurate.
That's all right. It suffices for a start. And that is why we've called you here, Master Kenway. We'd like for you to travel to America, locate the storehouse, and take possession of its contents.
I'm yours to command, although a job of this magnitude will require more than just myself.
Of course. Upon this paper are the names of 5 men sympathetic to our cause. Each is also uniquely suited to aid you in your endeavor. With them at your side, you will want for nothing.
Well, then I'd best be on my way.
I knew our faith in you was not misplaced. We've booked you passage to Boston. Your ship leaves at dawn. Go forth, Haytham, and bring honor to us all.
Some fresh air might do me good.
Good morning, Doctor.
To you as well.
A question, if I may. Do you serve aboard the ship, or are you simply taking passage?
A bit of both, actually. I've been commissioned by the Royal Navy to study maritime illness. I'll be observing the crew during the journey. We have found that sailors fare far better on the open seas than the rest of us. I hope to discover why that is.
Well, I hope you are successful in your endeavors.
As do I. Thank you for the kind words.
A moment to talk?
Ah, a fellow Londoner. Good to see I'm not the only man of means aboard. Rupert Martin, pleased to meet you.
Haytham Kenway. Pleasure.
Seems we picked an excellent time to leave the city.
Oh?
You didn't hear about the murder at the Opera House?
No. What happened?
They're still trying to sort it all out. And I suspect they'll be at it for a good long while.
Any word on the motive?
They've ruled out robbery. So perhaps it was a business arrangement gone sour. Or something more personal. More lurid. Who knows? But I am glad to be away from it. The city grows more dangerous by the day.
and then all will be well.
Are you sure about that?
Of course. Have I ever led you astray?
Nah. Oh, you don't sit right with the others.
Have faith, my friend. You'll see.
Well, well. Seems our esteemed guest has deigned to grace us with his presence. You might want to head back to your quarters. Top deck's no place for tender Parnells.
So I thought. And yet here you are.
Fancy yourself a joker, eh? Let's see how funny you find this.
That's enough, Graves.
Stay out of this.
Listen to this, Hector. Thinks he can swagger on up here and declare himself king of the castle.
Please, fellas, call this off. If the captain sees us...
To hell with the captain! And to hell with you, Mills! Whose side do you want, anyway?
We're ready to go again if you are.
This is unwise.
Why is that? You think I'm afraid of you?
No. But you should be. Do you yield?
Never! How do you like these odds?
What's the meaning of this?
Captain!
Explain yourself at once, Mr. Kenway.
These folk...
We were simply passing the time with a bit of sport, Captain.
How about you pass the time by doing your goddamn jobs instead? I wasn't aware I was paying you to loll about. A word, please, Mr. Kenway.
Oh, I nearly forgot. There's your knife back.
I don't care for you, Mr. Kenway. I've had nothing but trouble since you came aboard.
Your problems have nothing to do with me.
I beg your pardon?
You're a poor leader, ill-tempered and cruel, and it's clear your crew has no respect for you.
Look. I don't want to argue. In fact, I need a favor.
Oh, this is rich.
I suspect some of the men intend to mutiny.
Really? What a surprise.
As I cannot trust any of them, I am compelled to turn to you.
And why should I help you?
Because if they do intend to betray, I'm the only hope you have of reaching America alive. Well, what will it be?
If what you say is true, what other choice do I have?
Thank you.
But let me be clear. Should you ever dare to insult or threaten me again, I'll not hesitate but to cut off your head myself. Are we understood? Excellent. Good day.
Mr. Kenway.
Captain?
Whatever they're up to, I believe it's coming to a head.
I'd best get to work.
He's cut our rations again. Claims we're not provisioned for such luxuries.
It's not right that he should feast on lamb and wine whilst we're stuck in tin fish and biscuits.
You looking for another fight? That it? Go away.
To say to you.
Quite the basting you gave Graves and Quill. Wasn't by choice.
Aye. Blockheads, the both of them. Where are my manners? Louis Mills. Pleased to meet you.
Atham Kenway. So, should I be watching my back?
I think the boys learned their lesson. They're normally not so nasty. Honest, it's just the past few crossings have been a bit rough.
Oh?
Captain's trying to cut costs, reduce rations, lower wages, more dangerous cargo. It's put the crew on edge.
Is there cause for concern, then?
Not if I can help it. But the captain needs to think about the way he treats his men.
I have some questions for you.
That's nice, but I ain't got time to gossip. Probably wouldn't have anything useful to share anyway. You want information? Try the cook or the doctor. Everyone's always chatting them up.
A doctor, if you have a moment.
Have you taken ill?
Oh, nothing like that. I was wondering if you'd heard any rumblings of trouble aboard.
What sort of trouble?
Unusual complaints or grievances. Men taking issue with the captain
or
the passengers.
You sound just like James. Like I told him, I've been much too busy with my research to notice anything not work-related.
And where might I find James?
The galley's your best bet. Now, if you'll excuse me...
Are you James?
Aye.
Atham Kenway. Pleased to meet you.
I know who you are.
I was hoping you could answer some questions.
I figured as much, but not here. Follow me. So, what do you want to know?
Have you seen or heard anything out of the ordinary since we left port? Anything that gives cause for concern?
Some of the men have been gathering at night on the upper deck. I've only caught bits of their conversations, so I couldn't say for certain what they're up to. But I suspect it bodes ill.
Is it a mutiny they're planning?
All I know is they've little love for the captain. Mills has been trying to talk him down, but there's only so much one man can do.
Thank you for the information.
I only wish to see us reach the colonies alive.
Evening, sir.
How are things?
Calm and quiet. Just the way I like it. What brings you topside?
Thought I'd wander a bit. Stretch my legs. That's all.
Take care where you tread. The deck hides all manner of danger in the dark.
What was that? Someone's throwing cargo overboard. But why?
Take his hat off. Keeps his face hidden too, so we can't see him watch it.
Quiet! He's cut our rations again. Claims we're not provisioned for such luxuries.
It's not right that he should feast on lamb and wine, whilst we're stuck with tinned fish and biscuits.
Curious. Most curious. Any news? Each night it's the same. I scout one area, and they drop the painted barrels from another. I'm going to need to recruit an extra pair of eyes. Maybe James or Mills.
Why are they doing this?
Near as I can tell, the barrels serve as markers. They're leaving a trail. My fear is it's only a matter of time before whoever's following it...
Ship sighted aft! She's making ready to fire!
Beat to quarters, men! Ready the... Brace! Everybody down! A warning shot! Seems they don't mean to sink us, but board us instead! Man the cannons! Make ready to fight! I want you below decks!
Why? Let me help you secure the ship.
Do you know how to rig a sail? To load a cannon? To wage war at sea? I didn't think so. Now return to your cabin. Or do I need to have you escorted? Secure the hatch!
Haytham.
Have you been topside? A ship's appeared and means to board us. It's strange. There's no sign of mutiny aboard. Doesn't make sense.
Ah, but it does.
What do you mean?
Did you think you could escape from London so easily after what you did at the opera? That we wouldn't notice? That we wouldn't follow?
Ah. So that's what this is about.
Surrender, and I will see that you are treated with honor.
If you wish to treat me with honor, give me a sword.
Are you sure this is how you want to play it?
I told you to stay below decks.
I did as you asked. Only Mills was there waiting for me. He's the one that drew that ship here. There was no mutiny, only him.
What do they want?
Me.
Then they can have you.
Is that so?
You'll catch us anyway. There's nothing to be done.
I can think of something.
You wish us to sail into the storm?
It's our only chance.
I won't do it.
Then I will.
All right, all right.
I'll fix your sail for you.
Thank you.
Make ready for our arrival, men!
Arrival? I see no land, only this interminable fog.
The gulls tell us all we need to know. Climb into the crow's nest and you'll see.